हेलो फ्रेंड, माय सेल्फ लेक्चरर मिस अदिति अनिल कुशारे, मास्टर ऑफ फार्म्स इन क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस टेक्निक्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक एनवायरनमेंट एंड हेल्थ, दैट इज हेल्थ एंड एयर नॉइज फ्रॉम द हेल्थ एजुकेशन एंड कम्युनिटी फार्मसी। द टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड आर एज फॉलोज: हेल्थ एंड एयर, हेल्थ एंड नॉइज, ओवरऑल हेल्थ इफेक्ट्स बाय एयर। इवन हेल्दी पीपल कैन एक्सपीरियंस द हेल्थ इम्पैक्ट्स फ्रॉम द पोल्यूटेड एयर, इंक्लूडिंग रेस्पिरेटरी इरिटेशन और ब्रीदिंग डिफिकल्टीज ड्यूरिंग एक्सरसाइज और आउटडोर एक्टिविटीज। Your actual risk of adverse effects depends on your current health status, the pollutant type and the concentration and the length of your exposure to the polluted air. High air pollution levels can cause the immediate health problems, including aggravated cardiovascular and respiratory illness, added stress to the heart and lungs, which must work harder to supply the body with oxygen, damaged cells in the respiratory system. The long-term exposure to the polluted air can have the permanent health effects such as accelerated aging of the lungs, loss of the lung capacity and the decreased lung function, development of disease such as asthma, bronchitis, emphysema and possibly cancer. Then the shortened lifespan, those most susceptible to severe health problems from air pollution are individuals with the heart disease, coronary heart disease or congestive heart failure. Then the short-term exposure to particulate pollution are that can be aggravate the lung disease causing the asthma attacks and the acute bronchitis, increase the susceptibility to respiratory infections, cause heart attacks and arrhythmias in the people with the heart disease. Even if you are healthy, you may experience the temporary symptoms such as irritation of the eyes, nose and the throat, coughing, chest tightness, shortness of breath. Then the noise health effects are the physical and the psychological health consequences of the regular exposure to consistent elevated sound levels, elevated workplace or the environmental noise can cause the hearing impairment, tinnitus, hypertension, ischemic heart disease, annoyance and sleep disturbance. Changes in the immune system and the birth defects have been also attributed to the noise exposure. Although the age-related health effects, that is presbycusis, occur naturally with the age, in many countries the cumulative impact of noise is sufficient to impair the hearing of a large fraction of the population over the course of a lifetime. Noise exposure has been known to induce the noise-induced hearing loss, then the tinnitus, then hypertension, vasoconstriction and other cardiovascular adverse effects. The chronic noise exposure has been associated with the sleep disturbances and increased the incidence of the diabetes. Adverse cardiovascular effects occur from the chronic exposure to the noise due to the sympathetic nervous system's inability to habituate. The sympathetic nervous system maintains the lighter stages of the sleep. When the body is exposed to noise, which does not allow the blood pressure to follow the normal rise and fall cycle of an undisturbed circadian rhythm, stress from time spent around the elevated noise levels has been linked with the increased workplace accident rates and aggression and other antisocial behaviors. The most significant sources are vehicles, aircraft, prolonged exposure to loud music and industrial noise. There are 10,000 deaths per year as a result of noise in the European Union. Then noise-induced hearing loss. Noise-induced hearing loss is a permanent shift in a pure tone thresholds resulting in sensorineural hearing loss. The severity of a threshold shift is dependent on the duration and severity of noise exposure. The noise-induced threshold shifts are seen as a notch or on an audiogram from 3000 to 6000 hertz, but most often at 4000 hertz. The exposure to the loud noises, either in a single traumatic experience or over time, can damage the auditory system and result in hearing loss and sometimes tinnitus, as well as traumatic noise exposure can happen at work. For an example, loud machinery at play for an example, loud sporting events, then concerts, recreational activities, and or by accident, for an example, a backfiring engine, noise-induced hearing loss is sometimes unilateral and typically causes the patients to lose the hearing around the frequency of the triggering sound trauma. Environment and health, health and air noise learning outcomes are health and air and health and noise.